kick. It might be a caution as well for tagging that jersey. Not the smartest move if you ask me. It's Fatos who's down. Fatos taking that too. Well, not really needed. It was Mohamed Ali Khan of Lebanon. He's picked up a caution for that, all right. First caution in the game. And a good free kick opportunity here for Changchun Yatai. Will it be an Inio to take it? Will it be Sabolz Husti? Husti takes it! What a sublime shot! It's 1-0! Sabolz Husti has made this count here today, and now it's 1-0. That's also his third goal for Changchun in the season. That is a phenomenal free kick. Husti has got reason to smile here. What an effort it has been from him. The Hungarian makes the first goal in the game. 1-0 Changchun. Here's how it moves. Bends it beautifully straight into the left corner. It hits the target. Sabolz Husti. Born in East Gulch, Hungary. Works mainly as a left winger. Played for Ferencváros, Sopron, Metz, Hannover 96. For Hannover, he scored 17 goals in 81 appearances. Set at St. Petersburg, 7 goals in 58 appearances. That is a beautiful kick. I can watch that again and again. Returned back to Hannover in 2012 until this year, made 51 appearances, scoring 19 goals. It's been a champion since midway through the season. For Hungary, from 2004 to 2010, he scored 7 goals in 51 appearances. Known for his dribbling, pace, passing and goal-scoring ability from midfield. What a shot! That is the equaliser! That didn't take too long. And that is a phenomenal shot, and it's by Yu Feng. Well, that was the least expected. 1-1, and Tianjin are back in the game here. Well, Ari Han has got some reason to cheer. Surely came out of the blue. No one was expecting that. But here's Bai Yufeng, the man we know as Bai Lei. It's a smart pass that comes in from Barre. Andresinho picks it up. Andresinho moving it down the right flank. In comes Bai Yufeng, just inside the box. Angles that, shoots it, and slam! It's 1-1. Tianjin Teda are back in the game here today. For Guangzhou at one point of time. Guangzhou Pharmaceutical was known as Bai Lei. It's an Inio. It's brought down outside the box. Li Weifeng giving him a helping hand up. It was Li Weifeng with the challenge. Yufeng knocking away Nino's effort. Bessie Raj turns it back to at his end of the field. And to Rismalov. You didn't know this, Sabolz Husti, our first goal scorer, was a young Hungarian player of the year in 2004. The Hungarian Football Federation nominated him as one of the top three footballers in 2006. Just missed the award for best domestic footballer in Hungary. And that, of course, is coming from a country where you have greats like Frank Puskas. Puskas himself is such a legend. So fairly early, within the first 6 minutes, we've had two goals scored. Seemed like a chance for Chanchun to have knocked in the second goal here. Well, that could have been dangerous. Own goal opportunity, if you ask me. That's picked up safely by Song Sinyu. So no worries here for Lu Jianjun. Just looking back at Bai Yufeng, 27 years old. Comes from Yanbian Jilin in China, works as a fullback or a defensive midfielder. Started his career playing for Xiamen Lanxi. That was in 2006, 2008 to 2009, Guangzhou Pharmaceutical Giant Tianjin in 2010. Has made three appearances for the national team since 2010. What's interesting about him, he's also known as Bai Lei. And he's of Korean descent, but born and brought up in China. He was born to Korean parents, raised in China. Before he started his football career with the Beijing Guoyu team, he was considered a real talent and traveled to Serbia and Montenegro on a 3-year football training program. On his return, Team Inter Shanghai wanted him, but however he sustained a serious injury and the club ended their interest nevertheless. He joined promoted side Xiamen Lanxi since then. It's been a good ride for him. What's very sad is that when Guangzhou Pharmaceutical was demoted for a scandal in 2009, Bai refused to return to Guangzhou for pre-season training and instead looked for a transfer. Joined Tianjin Tera for a fee of 1.7 million yuan. Ari Han does favour him to work more as a fullback. He helped Tianjin in 2010 finish runners up. This is quite impressive. He also helped Tianjin win the Chinese FA Cup in 2011. Back to the action on field. It's 1-0 here. Even Stevens at the development area stadium. That's knocked out of line. Fairly easy by Zhao Haibin. That's straight through. Will be picked up safely by Song Zunyu. Well, from a distance, that certainly looked like a judo maneuver. But it wasn't. 13 minutes in. The score tied at 1-1. Remember, 3 more games to go after this, and we pretty much will reach the finale. Talking of it, so let's keep you in the loop on what's the current status. Guangzhou Evergrande will lead the Chinese Super League with 63 points. After 26 games played, Beijing won. Are on 57, which means Beijing are just 6 points behind. Beijing win a game today and Guangzhou Evergrande will suffer a defeat, it means Beijing will catch up with them. If Guangzhou Evergrande stretch their lead to 9 points, well, that pretty much will nail it. It will be a sure Guangzhou championship all over again, which where they seem to be heading, because they've got a goal difference of plus 44. Fatos Besiraj is totally upset about the fact that his foot has been knocked hard, the Montenegrin. Andresinho giving Besiraj a hand up. Hurt the most. Sometimes you can get your better tussle. You're knocked out depending on how badly it stamps, how badly your foot twists. Certainly looks like, well, since that early 7-minute blast that we had, things have just quietened down a bit for almost the last 10 minutes. Tianjin and Changchun are searching for chances. Tianjin Tera have played 26 games so far in the season, 8 victories, 7 games drawn, 11 defeats, 30 goals scored, 37 conceded, a goal difference of minus 7, 31 points in the bag. They've had 1 draw, 1 victory and 3 defeats in their last 5, which means it gives them only 4 points out of a potential 15. Changchun Lethai, on the other hand, have played 26 games. They have won the same number as the answer, that's 8, but they've drawn 6 and they've been defeated on 12 occasions. 30 points and 30 goals in the bag, 33 conceded, minus 33 the goal difference, 30 points is just a point behind that. Thank you. So while we spoke about Tianjin Teda and Changchun Yatai's standings on the table, yes, Tianjin looking for the second goal in the game. It's been a bit of a slow drawl, or I should say crawl, from 7 minutes all the way to 20. That's about a good 13. Opportunity, Changchun Yatai beginning to threaten. Here's Aninho closing in. This could be dangerous. That's a decent cross, but kept away by the Tianjin defense. And it's Li Weifeng and his men who are able to ward off the threat. 21 minutes in, well, we've just looked at the progress of Changchun Yatai and Tianjin Teda. But here's Changchun threatening again. Got an opportunity, or to throw in actually. Aninho will try to make the difference here. He's got good support today from Fatos Petiraj and Zabolt Hasti. Looking back at the other, well, results, Changchun Yatai lost 2-1 to Shanghai SIPG. That was a home game for Changchun. They were beaten 3-1 by Guangzhou RNF, 1-0 by Guizhou Renner, 1-0 by Shandong Luneng, 2-0 by bottom side, that's Harbinger Tango Cellar Dwellers, and they came back to winning ways with a 2-0 win over Jiangsu Senti. So it's been a very rough ride for Changchun Yatai. They've had 3 defeats, 1 victory, and then a defeat again. So Guizhou Renner, they beat Guizhou Renner 1-0, then lost another 2 and came back to beat Jiangsu Senti. So in their last 5 matches, Changchun have got 6 points out of a potential 15. Tianjin, on the other hand, only 4. Let's look at Tianjin's games. First, there was a 2-1 defeat at the hands of Guangzhou Evergrande, and a 2-1 defeat at the hands of Liaoning Huwen. Then they finally won a game and they beat Shanghai Shenzhen 1-0. That fell to Guanghangzhou Greentown 2-1. Fell to Beijing Guoan 2-1. And then a draw with Henan Jiangyu 1-0. The referee is saying keep it cool. It's going to be a hot opportunity. No way through for Changchun this time. It's under Ismail Orr, who gets ahead to the ball, but it's past the left post. Well, I did mention this earlier, Zhong Li used to play for Changchun Yatai for the longest period of time, and that's the change that we're looking at. Muhammad Ali Khan will come off, and in for him it's Ni Tao. Muhammad Ali Khan's got a cramp in his leg. He's also got a yellow card that he's been carrying. Come on. So that's the change. Nitao. Nitao replaces Mohamed Ali Khan. Decent effort coming in from the left flank from Bayou Front, but that's put wide. Good defence by Chang Xin Yatai. Andrazinho moves up to take the corner. Rakan. Okumi, better known as Rakan Okuka, man in charge. That's what he is. He's played for Henan. He tours to Tianjin. Tianjin's got a fairly decent lineup, actually. It's a bit of a surprise that they haven't been really making waves in the Chinese Super League. They're in eighth position. Today. Well, holds back Lee Xiaoting. Seven minutes in, the battle still rages on between Changshin and Tianjin. Johnson need a win very badly. Remember, it's a few games left, and to make the cut for the FC Champions League this year, the Changshin can still do it if they win all their games, including today's game. Game coming close. The Changshin attack and the Tianjin defense is held strong here. Zhongli and his band of merry men will keep any and every attack away. Coutinho. Simpson back quickly to Tao Yong. In the box, will it be a penalty? Doesn't seem like it, but it's going to be a free kick opportunity. He was brought out just outside. It's a good call by referee Lu Jianjun. Tripped just outside the danger area. Lu, of course, was hoping for a penalty. There's no doubt about it. Song Lee. He's been at the service of Tianjin for some time now. Will be taken by Li Tao. Thank you. kicking opportunity for Tianjin Teda. Could this be the chance that Tianjin take the lead for the first time in the game? That's the big question here. It was Changchun who serves the head first. Sun Jie, Lu Tianjun, who's going to take the kick here? Who's going to defend the kick taken by either Andrezinho or Borre? It's Andrezinho who knocks it straight against the Changchun defense. 35 minutes in, we're just 10 shy of hitting the 45, and it's been a fairly exciting start for us, but things just petered down along the way. Few top scorers in there. Eninho has scored the most for Changchun with 9 goals. Father Speshi Raj has scored 6. We've got Valencia who scored 5 of Tianjin. Zhao Haibin of Tianjin who scored 5. Du Xinyu and Huren Tian have scored 4 each for Tianjin. It's been a collective effort from the players, not one just dominated by a single goal scorer, as in Guangzhou. Selkison who's got 24 goals in the bag. They've got a sniffer for goal here. Zhong Lei will rush in to pick it up. It's been just one of those times when Zhong Lei has had his work cut out as well. Pato Speshi Raj in his level best to try and provide, try and hit the target. Well, that's what happens most often with some of the Chinese Super League games. They start off with a crack or with a bang. Zhong Lei. Once again, Changchun beginning to look dangerous. Tianjin in a spot of trouble. That's got to be a corner opportunity. Can Changchun make it goal number 2? By Yufeng defense, but well, that's not the best from him. Here's Yangchu. And Eninho to take the corner. This could be goal number 2. Well, unable to convert here. It's the Changchun front line. And it was Wang Wanpeng. Well, almost got a hand to the ball, but it looked like it came off Andrezinho's hand. Wanpeng. By Eninho and Fato Speshi Raj are making a huge effort to put Changchun ahead. Well, that was a bullet of a shot, but unable to get past the woodwork. And more than often, well, the crossbar will play spoil sport in the game. 5 minutes shy of hitting half time here at the Tivoli Interior Stadium as Junction Yatai and Tianjin Teda wage this battle in round 27 of the Chinese Super League. It's been a terrific effort so far from both sides. Here's Zhao Haibin. Knocks it straight back to Li Tao. Zhao Yao on the back line as well. Most of the area behind for quite a long time today. They fly straight up out of Special Raj. Nino smashing that one straight onto the crosswalk. Bit of power into that. Well, over the years in the Korean League, which is now known as the K-League Classic, Mourinho has scored some of the most impossible to score goals. Finding it difficult as well today. It's been tough for him to hit the target. Rosinho keeping a watch on the activity on the field. He'll take the free kick. Pradhan Okuka watching intently. Ahead by Zhao Haibin. Zhao stands back in. Rosinho wants to take the free kick. It's off to Li Bingqian. Back to Andrezinho. Bari slips it to Andrezinho. Andrezinho with the delivery. That's a decent ball in. Will anyone take advantage of it? Nobody. Stepping in to knock that ball away. Does Velio. 1-1 Pung. Got Lee Siamting and Sun Jie on hand at all times to defend. Senior knocked over. And the caution handed out to Lee Siamting. Sun Jie, who picks it up, sorry. And that's looking like dangerously for Song Zinyu, stepping out of position with the goal exposed to Li Bingqian. He's got the ball to Andrezinho. Andrezinho looking for Bai Yufeng, and one touch pass back, which will be intercepted by Bessie Raj. And here's Aninho for Junction Yatai. Aninho looking for a way through. He decides that he's going to work the area himself. Delivery that will be knocked away safely by Cao Yang. And here's Zhang Lei. Zhang Lei holding on Jolie to the ball. That's denial Li Xiaoting the strike. We've got a bit of added time thrown in for stoppages. There won't be too much because there weren't any really big fouls or huge delays on field. A game that I took recently a couple of months ago had 8 and a half, 9 minutes actually of added time. It seems to pass this across the field, of course, it's not knocked out. So he has the ball to Hussey sends it down to Ismailov unable to keep the ball within the line of play. They throw an opportunity for Canton. The referee glances at his watch as well. So half time at the Develop Interior Stadium at Changchun Yatai and Tianjin Tera go level on score into the break. Goal scored by Zabols Husti put Changchun Yatai ahead fairly early in the game. An equaliser from Bayou Feng putting Tianjin back on level footing. So half time score is Changchun Yatai 1, Tianjin Tera 1. Stay with us for second half action to find out which of these two clubs will claim maximum points today in this mid table battle.
Thank you. said Jamara. I said the middle third of him is the job.
Yeah.
Welcome back to second half action at the Develop Interior Stadium with Changchun Yatai and Tianjin Teda resume their round 27 battle. It's Evan Stevens as the side stick to the field for the second period, with Szabolcs Haszti, the Hungarian, scoring the first goal for Changchun Yatai, and just a minute later Bayu Feng nailing the equalizer of Tianjin Teda. So Changchun Yatai 1, Tianjin Teda 1 is how we start our second half action. Fairly interesting game here so far. Into second half action. It's going to be an interesting 45 minutes here. Because this is a side that has a very strong, or that shares a strong rivalry over the years. But let's not forget, it was a 3-goal result in the first encounter between the sides this year, 17th of May. And Tianjin Teda winning by the odd goal in 3. So Changchun will be eager here to make the difference, especially Raj with the assist, and Inio trying to move that one through. And it's the ball's Husti. Well, who's unable to knock that in. Seen whether he can help uplift the team, their current status. Changchun beginning to look very dangerous in the early part of the game. Songlei will pick that up safely. Lee Xiaoting trying to make the difference up front. closing in on 15 minutes here. Johnson Mathai still making the effort. Quick run from 1-1 Pong. It's pulled away by Zahai Bin. Yes, Andrew Rosinio now for Tianjin Teda. Gets past the half line. Andrew Rosinio. Barry, it's been a bit silent for the most part of this season. Such a talent otherwise. Matthews and you. We're trying to glance that through as Barry puts it past the left post. Sorry, Ni Tao. Not happy at all. And Zhongli makes the collect. Changchun back line, even though Tianjin Teda's attack was closing in. Trying to chip that over twice, but unsuccessful. Strong resistance being put up there by Zhao Haibin. So, not just special round, just a bit frustrated. It's best to get that through. Zhao Haibin and Cao Yang in the way. The second time around, Zhao Haibin. Almost like a dance that he was doing. Dragon dance. And we've got to play it out. Stand a chance here of pulling off a win if they can battle the might of the Tianjin defense, which has been fairly strong. Thank you. met since 2006. Tianjin Teda and Changchun Yatai have faced each other on 17 encounters. Out of those 17, Changchun have won 9. Tianjin Teda have won 4, and they've drawn on 4 occasions. Well, the last game was won by Tianjin Teda 2-1, so left to be seen whether Changchun can exact sweet revenge today, because in 2013 both teams won a game apiece. ...55 minutes in. It's been fairly silent on the Tianjin side of the border. Well, they've just been a bit quiet. Scramble in the box, Zong Lei. They will appeal for the fact that it was Changchun that got the last touch of the ball, and Inio probably. Marcus, it's still 1-1 here. Kukop is livid. Supports Husty unable to do much, and that's why Kukop just moved to that. Himself, Tianjin Tera, of course, is owned by the Tera Group. The name comes from the initials of the Tianjin Economic Technological Development Area. Old Stadium. It's located in the Kelton Economic and Technological Development Area. Now, what's very interesting, of course, is that since 2004, they've always been a team that's been closer to the top five. They finished sixth on five occasions, fourth on two occasions. Then, in 2010, they finished second, which is quite impressive. Runners-up, that is, in the China Super League, right behind Shanghai Pudong. 2011, they finished 10th, 8th in 2012, and 11th in 2013. And this is put past the right post, so no worries here at all. And Rosinho, eager to put Tianjin ahead in the game. Arend Haan, better known to us as Ari Haan, is a former Dutch footballer who's had the coach of Tianjin got a message on him. Lovely header though from Rosinho. Just going back with that right. Ari Haan has played for the Netherlands from 1972 to 1980. 35 appearances with 6 goals. Also played alongside the great of Dutch football, Johan Cruyff. Has played for Ajax Amsterdam, Anderlecht, Standard Liège, PSV Eindhoven and SICO. 71 goals in 419 appearances. The other teams that he's managed, and he's been very successful: Antwerp, Anderlecht, Stuttgart, Nuremberg, Standard Liège, PAOK, Feyenoord, Panathinaikos, Austria Vienna. He was the coach of the China People's Republic of China national team from 2002 to 2004, coach of the 2004 Asian Cup, and in charge of Persepolis in 2006, Cameroon, Albania, Chongqing Lifan, 2010 to 11, Tianjin Teda, where he made his former captain, Li Weifang, the captain. This is a good chance here to take the lead, and what a save by Song Zhenyu. Tianjin Teda denied, and this time Andresinho fails to nail it. Barry was on course for a goal. A terrific save, and that ball packed in a lot of power. Was just talking back about, looking back at Ari Haan. Now, he's been a coach in Netherlands, in Germany, in Greece, in Vienna, and that's in Austria, China, Iran, Cameroon, Albania. He's been all over the world. In fact, 2012, he was in charge of Shenyang Shenbei. He was called back to help Tianjin at the start of the season, and he will help Tianjin finish in the high register. There's no doubt about that. Can they secure a Champions League qualification for next year? That's a big question. Because chasing that spot, of course, are teams like Beijing Guoan, Guangzhou RNF, and Shandong Luneng, who are on 57, 47, and 44 points, respectively. Well, the giants of the China Super League, they're right up there. Beijing Guoan giving Guangzhou the ground a good run for their money this year. Let's not forget Guangzhou the ground. They've lost only 3 games in the season. 3 draws, 3 games, and 20 victories. But their 3 games that they lost, they lost both the games against Changchun Lethai. Changchun emerging as their bogey side. Chance here for a second goal! And he spots that past the keeper. Has that been ruled out? Fatos Messi Rad Saint. But what's the problem there? So it's still 1-1. Was it offside? Did he walk into the trap? Well, he most certainly would have. The flag had already gone up. Fatos Messi Rad unable to provide the lead. Closing in on 70 minutes now. That's a decent ball in. Appreciation there from Du Zhenyu. Oh, right post and no way through. Zhong Lei didn't blink much of that. It's an Inio. Can't hit the target from a distance. And Inio, for some reason, not looking his usual sprite himself. He's looking a bit tired. Wonder whether it's the heat or the humidity that got to him. Zhong Lei slips, Zhong Lei falls, and Zhong Lei will get up. Get past Song Zhenyu, and Song Zhenyu makes the save against a rather average effort from Bore. That's picked up by Song Zhenyu this time, so no way through. Looking back at Andre Zinho, whose real name is Andre Luis Tavares. When he played in the Korean League, he was known in the K-League Classic, he was known as Tavares. And if you recall, well, he started his career playing for Flamengo in 2001, but 2004 to 2007 he played for Pohang Steelers, 19 goals in 87 appearances. Moved to play for Nova Iguaçu in 2008, then Internacional, Botafogo, and joined Tianjin in 2013. The other player we have to make mention of is Muhammad Ali Khan, who's a Swedish-Lebanese footballer. He's off the field now, was injured in the early part. Until 2013, he believed he was born in 1986, but after locating his original birth certificate, discovered he was really born in 1988. Now, how harsh is that? But it's actually a gift to find out you're 2 years younger than you think you are. Which means, of course, he had made his Super Eton first team debut at the young age of 15. John Tianjin had started the season, 4 appearances for Lebanon since 2013. He's played for Wastra, Frölunda, IFN, BK Hakken. Here's Aninho to take the free kick for Johnson Yatoy. Over nice and easy. Zhao Haibin gets in the way. We pulled away by Bayou Fung. Zhang Chun have got things under control. The Songs are new. Safe than sorry approach. The two keepers. Zhong Lei, now 33 years old, 62 inches. Started his career playing for Tianjin Teda in 2001. Unfortunately, he never got a chance to play, making only one appearance at that point in time. And the reason for it was, well, there wasn't much opportunity. Moved on to play for Shandong Luneng in 2004 to 2005, but due to Deng Xiaofei being the main keeper, he was replaced often. So finally joined Changchun Yatai in 2006 and made 141 appearances for them in 2012. That was a free kick opportunity for Changchun. Zhong Lei, keeping safe. Joined Tianjin Teda back again last year. He's made 12 appearances for China, 2007 to 2009. The other keeper, Song Zhenyu. Song Zhenyu, of course, has played for a number of teams. We've got a change here. Since he will be replaced by Peshuai. Peshuai comes in for Sun Jie. Well, talking about the Changchun keeper, Song Zhenyu. He's now 33 years old. 33 on September 21st. 12 appearances for China from 2007 to 2009. He's played for Sichuan Quanxing, Chongqing Lifan, Dalian Shida, Sichuan Guangcheng, Shenyang Ginde, Chengdu Blades, Tianjin from 2011 to 2012. So it's interesting that both, well, while he came to Changchun Yatai in 2013, Song Lu returned to his old club, Tianjin. Funny pull there from Messi Raj, but it's Li Benjian. Gets a word from the referee. And was that for a foul? It was for a foul on Zawal Sasti, so it's going to be a free kick, which is why Bessie Ross let that go. It was a foul on Cao Tian Bao by Li Benjian. Here's an Inio. Getting a helping hand from Li Weifeng, not the kind that he'd want to. This time it's turned away fairly easy. And Inio, well, not really pushing that kick too hard. Chops his own leg. Down. opportunity for chance of the attack. Standout factor in this part of the game has been Zhongli, the former Chongqing and current Tianjin Taylor keeper. Well, has put on a splendid performance today. We've got to say hats off to that. Such a big miss here. All it needed was guidance. So Medusa knew is one of the men with the best foot on field, and he's failed to knock that in. Didn't read that too well. Here's how it all panned out. So Haibin with the assist. Medusa knew needed to knock that in. It's a sweet assist from him. The closest person to knock it in was Huren Tian, and well, it serves the junction defense well to have let that go. It could have been an own goal otherwise, but such a good setup from Du Zhenyu. And Huren Tian, well, fails to score the winner. Well, time moves on here. We're just about 3 minutes shy, plus a bit of added time thrown in, of course. before we call it time in this game, or before the referee calls it time in this game. Hasn't been the best performance from either side, but they've held their own, and that's what really counts. Action that we're looking at towards the closing minutes of the game. Let's remind you, we've got only three more rounds to go after this. A couple of teams still have to play out their round 26 games, so that Shanghai Shenzhen and Hangzhou Greentown still got a game in hand as compared to the other Chinese Super League rivals. It's going to be a free kick opportunity because Savos Hasti is brought down. Huran Tian. The media will take it. That's a lovely ball in. No way through it. Bai Yufeng. Looking strong for his side. Ball away very easily. This time it's on late. Punches the ball to safety. Ivan Kuka, the man who took Jiangsu Shenji to new heights. Their respective games, they'll go ahead of these two clubs. to sneak that one in. And quickly moving to take the corner was Andres Zinho. That was fairly quick and that's picked up by Song Zinho. And it's all over here at the Development Area Stadium in Changchun with Changchun Yatai and Tianjin Teda finishing the level. It was a goal scored by Sepals Husti in the first period that would have earned Changchun the victory, but an equaliser by Yu Feng just a minute later put Tianjin level. That's how much remained right through this game. It's the final score at the Development Area Stadium. It's Changchun Yatai 1, Tianjin Teda 1. I'm Glenn Mascarenhas saying goodbye for now, but we'll catch you again with more Chinese Super League action later on in the day.
马春旭一不急不带，你们这腰额还不少呢。小江给他机会了，他不能放过呀。
小江，我操，那岂不是他会挡住整个板子？
这放运的比例就不对了。哎呦我操！
北方其实也不错，你是哪里人？我是东北人。你看我们车队要怎么踩不踩呀？快点啊！哎，我今天起来打电话呀，今天起来混乱了，
该离了。